and welcome to the TD Club at Tribune-Democrat. I'm Sean Curtis, joined by Mike Mastovich. We're looking at the Saturday games in our Week 11 playoff slate. We'll start with District 6A, Bishop McCourt, host Marion Center. The Stingers a big winner over Salzburg in the first round. McCourt had the first round bye, and the Crimson Crushers look to be the favorites, but don't overlook the Stingers.
Yeah, the Stingers 7-3. They have played a pretty tough schedule. You know, they've gone head-to-head with Ligonier, United, Penns Manor. They're always tough in playoffs. McCourt coming off the bye week, playing on Point Stadium turf. They'll be right at home there in both senses of the word. And we'll look at Kevin Sheridan's first game as head coach in the playoffs.
On to 5-6-AA. Six of the teams have an 8-2 record or better. Two of those teams, Forest Hills, Penn Cambria, the 5 seed at the 4 seed. And this is a rematch of a late season game, which Forest Hills won 24-0. But the Panthers have picked up the play since then.
Yeah, I talked to Coach Ernie Fetzer last night, and he talked about the game they played the last time. It also was at Crescent. And he said that while Forest Hills won fairly one-sided, 24-0, he felt there were a couple of plays, as in any game, a couple of plays that turned things around. He believes that was a lot closer than that 24-0 score indicated. And as you said, Penn Cambria has played extremely tough as of late. They've just rolled into these playoffs. They've earned a home field advantage for this first round. Coach Fetzer hasn't said it, but they're another team that maybe could say, hey, we're the forgotten team, because they've been the underdog in a lot of games that they ended up winning.
And moving on to District 5A, Northern Bedford is at Winbur, and the Ramblers had a bye. They're the 2 seed in District 5, and some people are looking at what Berlin did to the Ramblers in Week 9 as the blueprint to stopping Winbur, and that's containing Colin Bryan.
Oh, yeah, that's a no-brainer. Colin Bryan, 1,951 rushing yards, 30-some touchdowns. The guy is a force. And then if you look at him on defense, oh, my goodness, I saw him at safety. He just makes play after play. So, obviously, he's the focal point of any defensive effort. Wimber's going to have its hands full on defense as well. Last week, Matt Sullenberger for Northern Bedford, 302 rushing yards.
Logan Fluke, our Eric Knopfsnyder covered the game. He said he was 15 of 15 passing. They can mix it through the air or on the ground. And as we know, Jeff Batesel's team's in Northern Bedford. He's one of the, he's not in our coverage area, but he's one of the best coaches around. I mean, the guy just does it year in and year out. So I look with Matt Grohall, the job he and his squad have done this year. This is going to be a pretty nice game to see.
And Johnstown fans, don't think that we forgot about the Trojans. The Trojans are on a bye this week because there is no District 6 AAA final. Belfont finished with a 1-9 record, did not enter the postseason. So the Trojans will wait. They will have either Clearfield or St. Mary's next Saturday, and that'll be at Mansion Park. That'll be a 1 p.m. kickoff. So it'll be the first afternoon game the Trojans have played since Westmont.
Yeah, the Trojans, they had the big win at Forest Hills last week, and they had a couple injuries in that game. Mark Watson was a guy, the very effective defensive back. That'll give him a chance to see if he can come back from a hand injury, and a couple other players got nicked up there. And, it's kind of a downer that you don't get a chance to defend your District 6 AAA title that you've won the previous 2 years. But what can you do? We've talked about this earlier. It's only 2 teams in 6 AAA at this point, and if one of them's 1-8 or 1-9, obviously that's not a playoff-type team. So they'll have to take the week off and hope to do well against District 9.
And we would like to thank Roger Bonham for taking time out of his weekly preparation to talk to us and add a little insight into their matchup with Richland this Saturday. For the TD Club, I am Sean Curtis. This is Mike Mastovich, and we wish you a happy football weekend wherever it is you may be headed.